Well, this is going to be an episode of I Told You So's by about half of my viewers. I decided to see if it was possible to print the ESP8266 boards on one layer. You know, using that magical process I have that totally prints circuit boards in half an hour, I did all my tricks, jumping through a voltage regulator, snaking things around, little bits of 0805 parts, all sorts of little things in order, even there, I tried routing in between the pins on a soic pad. I'm surprised that the printed, it did, I underexposed a little bit, so it was a little rough, and I had to add a jumper. But it printed, everything was fine, except for the fact that it's terrible. It's just utterly terrible. There's no ground plane, there's no nothing, there's no, you know, these little circuit boards here, they got no back. It's just a plain old circuit board. So these circuit boards right here have the ESP8266, a voltage regulator, and a flash, and they're actually for my color cord system, this particular one, so I have a little electric mic right there. I was able to program it, and I was able to get it to come up. Oop. So it does connect, and it does communicate. The fastest it seems to go is very dependent on the orientation, since I'm using a little chip mic, which you'd expect. The only thing you would not expect, or at least I wouldn't, is that it would be able to get extremely, extremely terrible. You can actually see on the oscilloscope when the chip gets worse in different orientations. So if I hold my thumb to the back of the chip, it does that. If I hold it by the sides, it does that. And you can hold it by different orientations and it can get just straight up awful in some orientations. This is stuff coming in on my ADC, so it's really just not feasible to have this circuit try to run this whole thing. So just by orienting it differently like this, it goes from bad to terrible. In fact, I'm pretty sure there's no orientation I can put this in where I would even be able to find other nearby networks. I mean, it's just so awful. Just trying to orient this to some semblance of a functional is just painful. So, this did not work. And just so you guys can compare, that's this board, this one-layer board. And here is one of the ones with an ESP01. It's way more stable, way more reliable. There's nothing even hooked up to the T-out pin on this one. And it's still able to get something kind of calm on the oscilloscope. Well, let's zoom out here a little bit. Let me get that to relink. Fresh. So yeah, even this, it's pretty much orientation independent at this point. I'm moving it around and really nothing is changing. And I really think that, unfortunately, I'm going to have to concede there are some applications where I think two layers might be useful to have on a circuit board. All right, I admitted it. You guys win.